Welcome to the program, Roxanne.
Thank you so much, TWBA. Wow.
Is this a new look?
This is just a regular look. It's a regular 3-hour to be here look.
Ah, talaga? Sa TNT ang iyong, how do you call that? Your title, your sobriquet. Contra Diva ng Makati.
Yes.
Oh my gosh. Do you like that? The Contra Diva ng Makati?
I think it's the wittiest, nice. Wittiest na title that they gave me. Na,
okay.
Nakakaya naman, Tito Boy, to correct. Sexy Contra Diva.
I wanted to get it right. Sexy Contra Diva ng Makati.
Baka kasi... Yeah. Diba? Wala lang. Nahiya talaga ako. I'm blushing.
No, but you know, I think I caught you during your episode sa TNT. Was it Dulce who said, Dulce bang nagsabing come back to singing?
Miss Dulce and Miss Shasha were very encouraging.
Yeah, I saw that. Na parang, you know, people have to be reminded that you are actually a singer, that you started as a singer.
Tito Boy, including myself.
Talaga?
Binabaon ko talaga siya.
Bakit?
In the back of
Bakit?
My head. It comes with a lot of, wow! Woo, Tito Boy, I can't lie to you. Wait lang.
Yeah.
There's so much feelings going on.
That's okay.
It comes with a lot of trauma. When I was 18, I was parang gifted a album recording deal with Universal Records, and I had no idea that the owner of it, Belyatan, Miss Belyatan, had she had cancer.
So take me to the trauma. How did it become a trauma?
She passed away.
Oh,
after
she did.
After namin ma-release ang album, nag-number one ang Kung Alam Mo Lang, na hindi alam ng mga tao na si Roxy is Roxanne Barcelo. After that, I said I will never sing again. Because she's the only one who believed in me at that time. Apart from my parents, of course.
Okay.
But then talaga yung fears that come with it.
Tonight with